Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Let's Play Modular Mayhem Reloaded with Trix 2. I have been informed by Iskandar and Main Freak, and I believe Linsman Roz also knew this, that you no longer make the wand first. You have to make the table that I cannot remember the name of now. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, the Luminous Crafting Table, which you can't actually find in JEI, I don't think. Hafting? Well, it occurs to me I could have just searched for Astral Sorcery. Yeah, Luminous Crafting Table, it doesn't have a JEI recipe. This does. Starlight Crafting Altar does, but the Luminous Crafting Table doesn't. Okay. But it's fine. I've gone back to my base and grabbed the things I need to go ahead and make it. And one luminous crafting table, which has expanded my vision, and apparently now I can do a whole bunch of things, including make the... Is this even the right one? Nope, this is not the right one. I need this one, Discovery, which is tells me all about making the resonating wand, which apparently needs the table, which I have completely forgotten to bring the... Unless I remember to bring a... Did not bring a spare teleporter. Well, you know what? That's fine. Let's go ahead. Whoop. Go home. And we're now on the dev, not dev version. We're now on version 1. Why am I flying? I don't have to do that. Shift P. There we go. And Shift P. We can teleport home. Oh, I didn't clean this up. Oops. Didn't necessarily mean to clean. Break that. Yeah, I've made a hardened reservoir to pick up lava and dropped it in here. So now we've got 90 buckets of lava sitting here for when we need to make stuff with the industrial furnace. Excuse me. We should also have at platforms. Yeah, we now have platforms. That was not in the version I had last time, so. What about you? Okay, we have everything we need. We just need to go find a red flower and pulverize its face off. That'll work. I believe that we now have thermal were we supposed to have thermal innovation? Alright, we do not. I believe Iskandar said he was going to wait a version to make sure all the bugs got removed. These recipes have been simplified a little bit so that mana dust? Okay. So pyrolithium no longer requires the coal or charcoal, and cryothium no longer I think it's cryothium that no longer requires niter, which was some people found a pain to get. I was not bothered, but what are you stone cover. So basic I love the fact that there's one crafting recipe for just the stone cover visible here, but I think if you this will show all the others if you find uses for a structural duct. This is the way to do it, as opposed to other mods where, you can craft this, everything into this. Right, so we don't have thermal innovation, which is fine. I'm annoyed because I just made a Batania magnet in my custom series, and we don't have, and then thermal innovation became a thing. However, we do have everything necessary for the Coin of Fortune. I went out and found everything. This might actually be even better. The thermal innovation option can do that same thing. Hold right click and it vacuums up everything nearby. You know what? You're gonna be in my... I don't think I should need you in my inventory. Yeah, it's very fast. Okay. Look, just come with me. Thank you. Here, you go back in there. Actually, tell you what. Let's put you in there instead. Add that. Oh, no, I need that. I need the chaos order to be in there. There we go. Alright, let's go make our wrench. Which. Platforms. Right, I'm doing this while I wait for the sun to go down. I need that, and then I need the monkey wrench. Because the monkey wrench is vital to making platforms behave themselves. So this is all spruce. Which spruce do I have? I have a fair bit of spruce. Now metal, I don't require if metal. Let me try that again. I don't remember if metal needs the ingots or the blocks. So let's not you. We'll get to you shortly. I'll put this over here with all the decorative stuff. So this is platforms. And basically, you wanna make a platform, you click that. Do I need no, I can use ingots. So I can take and grab these platforms here. And we can where's my I need my axe. Axe is it in here, I think. Nope, axe is in my inventory. Good job. So much YouTube brain. Alright, so if I we'll take that and actually I'm gonna leave. Oh, right, I have my coin. Alright, let's fly, shall we? So we can take that and place it there. And it looks okay. But we can also take our monkey wrench and now which one of you it does occasionally take quite a few clicks to right, let's see. Yeah, that works. Right. So now we have this platform here. If we come back over to this, we can click over to this. And we take this in, right click it there, and now we have a railing. I'm not terribly sure I like this. Can I just. Aha! I can! Excellent. I can put that there, and now I have this platform here. These are actually climbable, as if they were ladders. Okay, stop falling off, thank you. Yeah, so this is what how I'm gonna fancy this up. I'm not sure I like that texture from the iron. Fortunately, we come back over here. I believe we can put it here. Yeah, we put the materials here, and then we can reclaim the materials that are there. Let me get andesite's the one that I've found that I really, really like as a. It's probably more andesite than I actually needed. Yeah, let's try this. Oop. You know, we'll deal with that in a minute. But yeah, that turns out to look very nice. It looks better if I use dark oak wood, but the dark oak doesn't fit the platform. I will go ahead and play with this and see what looks really nice. However, oh, okay, go away. That's not what I wanted. However, what I want to do is put this down and all right, hopefully that's enough starlight to make the resin 18. Need to make the resonating wand, which is two aquamarines, a pearl, and any marble. I believe astral sorcery marble. Oop. Alright. Astral. And then. Ender. one ender pearl. Let me take this, this, and that, and okay. Book? How do we get the... Okay. Okay. You know what? Do we... Oh. Alright, you know what? Fine. Because this is not behaving itself, and I don't understand why it's not. I'm going to do this. And give you a smack, which will, in a moment, yeah, give me a second resonating wand, I'll throw that away, we'll go back to normal mode, and we will pretend that I do not want to scream and throttle whoever decided that you can't have to have the table to make the table first in order to make the wand that you need to make stuff. Right, so, this has two different things. And one of the things... Go away. Ah, I think we're in a place... here we go. So, we take our Q-tip of Doom. And... burrow down. We're gonna use you. And... put this up here so that we are not... Q-tip of Doom, and then the power of hammer. That's a really annoying sound. So basically what we're going to do is drill down to the bottom of the world. That really is a very annoying sound. That's pipe. That's trollite ore. So we can keep drilling. I'm going to stop and... Alright, hang on. Really? Fine. We will just do it like this. I really need to make the flux-infused shovel as soon as I have the diamonds necessary for it, because... Excuse me. Oh, I'm out of inventory space. Well, that's less than helpful. Or rather, I'm not. I am simply... Alright, we have some of this. Alright, there we go. We'll go back to... burrowing downward, headed straight for bedrock. There we go. And being able to fly means that we should... right, you can go in there. Right. I need to go back upstairs because, well, frankly, I'm out of inventory space already. Out through the hole with our Q-tip of Doom. I swear, this really does look like a giant Q-tip. Cotton swab, if you're... Because I believe Q-tip is an American thing. Do that. That's better. You can all be smelted. Pretty sure that's everything. You go in. I just tossed some ore in there and I'm not sure what sort of ore it is. Or was, I mean. You can also go in there. You can also go in there. You. You. And you can all go in. I have discovered... where's that hole at? Ah, we're right here. Right, there we go. Alright, let's put down a torch here. And we will hammer a bit in each direction. Oh, that was the wrong direction. Okay. I hope there wasn't crystals over there. Oh, for pity's sake. Too much out lava in this part of the world. Ow. Oh. Just stop. Thank you. Right. Now we haven't gotten any rock crystals yet, which is kind of unhelpful. Go away, lava. Oh my goodness. Aha, here we go. Rock crystal ore. There's some rock crystals. Hammer. Teach me of these rock crystals. Do we see any more is the question. Hey, Lens, look. Nickel. I do like the fact that the magnets don't seem to have any trouble picking up, or the coin doesn't have any trouble picking up from. Right. So we got a rock crystal, a couple of rock crystals which are useful. Right. That seems to be all of them, I think. I love how this rain just falls straight down here. Hello. I see you there. Thank you. Go ahead and get this diamond and redstone because, well, diamond and redstone are two things you never have enough of. There we go. Now hopefully that's all the rock crystals available, but let's dig down a bit and see. Right. I'm thinking that is all of it. Right. All right. So we got. Oh, we got three. 201, 231, and 329. Now, Direwolf, I believe it was. Yeah, it was Direwolf who explained exactly what all those numbers meant, and it's cutting that makes no difference unless you're making tools. But purity and size are important, but even better, they're changeable. Cutting is the one that you. I'm gonna put a piece of basalt here so I know that this is a completed. An empty hole, essentially. I hear you there, creeper. Go away. Stupid creepers, anyway. Right. So, oops. Let's do that. That. And then we can come over here and this. I think lithium is the one that can't be bored up. And we'll throw that in there. And you are jam-packed because, of course, you are. We don't really need to be doing Chaos Essence. This is no use because, well, for one, it's raining, and for two, it's daytime. Excuse me a second. Sorry about that. So, do I have any obsidian? I think I do. And the reason I want to do some obsidian. Yeah. Let's see. We need. Right, you get out of my way. I would like to get into some pneumatic craft. Alright, so we make that 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. I want to get into some magnetic craft because I really like magnetic craft, and it's always been one of those mods that I need some TNT. How do I not have TNT? I could have sworn I brought TNT back from one of the desert temples. Or perhaps that was not in this mod pack that I found a desert temple. Actually, I can find out. It's you. And Elika's whoop. Right, here we go. One desert. I can make TNT. There is one advantage to being in deserts. It does not rain. Or rather, it rains, but no water falls out of the sky. Let's see if there's a desert temple around here. Oh, hello. Oil sand. That could be useful. Although not now. Because, well, I don't have any way to collect the oil that comes out of it. Oh, look. Another future pack dungeon. Those things, once you find them, once you recognize what they are basically everywhere. This does not appear as though it's going to contain... Oh, you got more immersive petroleum oil sitting here on the surface, which could be handy. No, I don't want the rain. Go away, rain. Yeah, once you recognize where the... why am I... Okay, hang on. Better way to do this. Alright, there we go. Now we're sprinting and flying. Oh, because it's a beach. Right, I appear not to have any... Right, I don't have any thing. Hello. One slightly mangled astral sorcery temple here. Did I loot this one already? I've looted this one already. Yep. Can I? I can't actually pick that up. All right, it'll break it. I think you can get the ability to do so later. Let's go ahead and head home, because I'm gonna have to make TNT. TNT. So basically, what we're going to do is make ourselves some TNT. Flint. I do have a flint. I have that flint and steel. Did I make the mining? No, I was going to make a mining tool for a mining world. Actually, give me a button. I don't have a button. Alright, that's fine. I have wood. I don't want anything that I don't... I'm not bothered about being exploded. Right, there's that. Give me some... I think I can do 2 stacks of iron and that's enough to get started. But basically what I'm going to do is come over here and make myself a blast tub. There we go. Oh right, I forgot I don't have to collect stuff anymore. I have an amazing magnet, and hopefully this tub should protect excuse me, sorry about that. I am going to need to take you and turn you off. Go away, you stupid chicken. Right, so hopefully if I go and throw those 2 stacks of iron in there and a button here. Okay, it needs more obsidian. Alright, okay, stop collecting that. That's not helpful. Right, you can't do that, by the way, with, any of the TNTs that don't destroy blocks, because they don't work. Tiny TNT from AE2 doesn't, neither did the old SDX from Tinkers and... Yeah, I'm going to need to fill in these corners with obsidian, but for right now, this should be as sufficient for what I want. So, at ENE... How are you spelling pneumaticraft? No. Okay. Ah, pneumaticraft. Right. So, welcome to Pneumaticraft Repressurized, which is a successor mod to the old school Pneumaticraft. Pneumaticraft being a mod which relies on air pressure for its power system, essentially. I played with this back in the original Modular Mayhem. And basically, to get started, you make these pressurized tubes, and it's glass and some compressed iron, which you can make with an explosion, or you can make with a, what do they call it? Pressure chamber. And in order to make a pressure chamber valve, you need pressure chamber wall. And I think it's two of these is enough for the, yeah, that's enough for the 3x3. Right. So we take that and that and that. Coin of fortune goes there. Sand can go away. Feathers. We'll put. Actually, rock. Put our rock crystal. Bring our rock crystals back, because it's now nighttime. Ah, and we've got stuff for which we can make the pressure chamber. Actually, we do need to make the pressure chamber valve. We need just one, because that's how we get pressure in. Yes, we okay. So we do have some astral sorcery thing. Now we need to make. Okay, no. Okay, stop it. Nope, we gotta. Do you mind? Thank you. Right. So our next step into astral sorcery is here, and we need to make. We actually kind of need to make the looking glass, which, yeah. So the looking glass, and then, alright, I'm trying to remember where we go from here. We've got crystals, crystal growth. We can basically adjust the size of our crystals. What we want to make is actually the looking glass, but we need to make it into a telescope. Because future pack telescope is not what we want. We need to make this, and this requires the second tier of starlight craft. Well, of course it does. Starlight crafting also requires a bucket of liquid starlight, which means we need to make a light well, and that we can do. And that's what requires the rock crystals, right? Marble. Get some more marble, unless it requires specific marble. Grab a couple of aquamarines, and we'll use the worst of these rock crystals, which is gonna be you. So it should be this and this, and you have to be, okay, 2 chiseled, 3 ruined. Marble? 2 chiseled. And, alright, well, we'll do that, and then we need our chisel, which is in this bag, that becomes 3 rune marble, which goes here, here, and here, and then you two go there. That's our light well, which needs the resonating wand. And we have just enough starlight to do that, I guess. Oh, it's telling me there's more rock crystals down there. That's useful. And we now have a light well. And the light wells, and we can put here for now. I need to take my wand and look around at night and find an area with. It's a blue-black sparkles on the ground. I don't see one. And we've now bumped up against the wrapping up point. But if we take an what's it, turquoise. If we take this and aquamarine and we take it and we put it right click it here, this will now begin collecting liquid starlight. And it takes a while. And we need a full bucket worth in order to make the next level of the crafting thing, which gets us the ability to make a telescope, which lets us move on. And alright, I'm going to rest through the night because this rain is getting on my nerves. Huzzah, the rain has finally quit. Right, so that's what this is what we need to make, but we need to be able to make the other crafting table, the Starlight Crafting Altar. Which, if I recall correctly, also needs a structure around it. I want to make another platform of these, specifically for Astral Sorcery, but that's something to do between episodes because it's going to be tedious and time-consuming, because I have to find a spot and then grow some trees, and then we'll be fine. But once I have it, I can put down a teleporter. I can put down a teleporter anchor, like that, and be able to. I'll make myself another return home charm that I can teleport to. Does that still? Yeah, that still works as long as there's an anchor there. It doesn't care that I accidentally busted it. But we'll also get a little bit of pneumaticraft on the go. That will probably be. I'll probably do a platform over here. It might be a little lower than the others. I do still have my neon crystals growing. Apparently you can use this in an infusion generator. Lensman was working on it, and it will turn it into dust you can smelt into neon ingots instead of having to make them out of charcoal or coal and that. Alright, so this has been Modular Mayhem Reloaded with Trax 2. I will see you guys next time. Bye.